Om Sai Ram. I offer my most respectful pranams at the Divine Lotus Feet. Dear brothers and sisters, I am indeed grateful for this opportunity for sharing some of my thoughts with you in this August gathering. Mr. Mittal struck the note that one of the important aspects which need to be emphasized in this current context is the standing up to principles and fighting for ethics in public life. In fact, I recall my stint as Education Secretary to the Government of India and later as Central Vigilance Commissioner, where I had occasion to see that it is fundamentally the character which matters. And no amount of punishment, no amount of follow-up is really going to be effective unless fundamentally the character is conditioned to be of the highest order. And Bhagwan Baba's work all through has been to emphasize on this central aspect of education, which is end of education, is character. Bhagwan also says that education is for life and not for living. What a contrast to what is obtaining in the present day. And Bhagwan Baba's vision is that Vidya has to be in the perspective in which it was envisaged all through. Atma Vidya, Vidyanam Atma Vidya. So that is the education about the self. In fact, his approach is to assist each one of the students to acquire self-knowledge so that they are in a position to develop self-confidence, which will enable them to do self-sacrifice in order to enable self-realization. These are the four hallmarks which need to be kept in view in any aspect relating to education. Is educational institutions offer education free right from the KG to the PG level? So many schools, elementary and high schools, and a university which preserves the highest standards in terms of teaching and learning, and more than anything else, it is the character formation which is emphasized by Bhagwan Baba. Character and action, these are the two hallmarks of the entire educational system. And this Vidya, which his students imbibe, develops so much of self-confidence in them that they are today spread all over the world and do whatever seva they can in their respective communities. I need to harp upon, to some extent, how this transformation takes place. For example, in the university, Satya Sai University, you have a living which is characterized by community living. Each individual lives not only for himself, but for all the rest. In fact, the students are from all over the country, selected purely on the basis of merit, and they share their accommodation in a common spirit, evening out the rough edges, and learning to know how to live together. And that really lays emphasis on collective performance. It's not so much the individual performance, it's not so much the competition, but it is coordinated effort. And they live in a strict atmosphere of discipline. Bhagwan Baba says, discipline is the medium of instruction in his institutions. The first Second and third language are love, sacrifice and sadhana. So what a noble approach to the entire course of education. So they learn to live in order to sacrifice. They learn in order to share the fruits of their learning with the community. And it is this motivation which really leads them on to greater and greater roles in the community. What Bhagwan says is always that you live for the society, you are a limb of the society, and that's what you need to realize. You have no existence other than being a member of the society. You have to give to the society much more than what you take from it. That is the bounden duty of every citizen. It is this which really lends hope to the students, these Sai students who are spread all over the world. I will only narrate two instances. Thousands of them gather on the 31st of December to pay their love and respects to their spiritual mother, Bhagwan Sri Satya Sai Baba. No other institution you can see such number turning out with their families, with their children, and staying. It's a matter of great rejoicing for them to come on the appointed day and take Swami's blessings. Service of this nature is all over. In whatever form one can possibly do in their respective communities, it varies from community to community. It was one thing in Canada, the other thing in the US, a third in Latin America, a different type of service in Africa, a different type of service in Newland, a whole range of institutions, whole range of services, all towards the service to humanity. This is what has come to be stressed, and they are living examples of this lesson of love and seva. And as Mr. Mittal was mentioning, the spirit of seva is the most important, and that's what Swami stresses. Says the Upanishadic teachings, he is not tired of teaching, repeating them at all. Whatever he says is Upanishadic. For example, looking at seva, an example of which is Gram Seva, where we distribute saris and dhotis and the prasad Bhagavan during the course of a week, almost covering a population of 1 lakh plus. It says, give to everyone with faith, and do not give without faith. Serve him right at his doorstep. Go and inquire whether it has been done properly, and go when you serve, have the feeling whether he is going to accept it. At that sense of trepidation is with you. Don't take the other person for granted. It's an opportunity for you to serve. It is in that capacity service has to be done. And as Bhagavan was mentioning, all the services, particularly three aspects, Vidya, Vaidya and Water, these have to be given free, and free to everyone. You will be interested to know, the university doesn't charge a pie from its students. No types of fees. Education is offered absolutely free. The same way, if you look at the super speciality hospitals, where everywhere else it is so expensive, running into lakhs, the unique feature is there is no billing department in these super speciality hospitals. Nothing is collected from the patients, and that is made known to them. And this is the spirit of service. And before I conclude, I would like to say, oftentimes the question is raised when we have the conferences of vice chancellors and other luminaries. It is possible for Bhagwan to do because of his divinity. Is it possible for us to repeat? Are these replicable? And having been there, having seen them perform, I can honestly assure that it is almost totally replicable. What is there is not merely divinity. It has been possible because of the divine vision. But more than 90% of it, you can say, is hard sweat and blood and effort of Swami. Everything has been put into such detail. Everything has, so much of time and effort has gone into the making of each of the institutions, in identifying the resource persons, in watching the performance, in making sure that basic principles are never violated, and more than anything else, the love and affection, the selfless love which he has been able to show to the students, to the everyone who passes through, that has been the major factor. And that, I suppose, to any dedicated individual, Bhagwan will be able to bless that it is being capable of being replicated. And that is the effort which is called for. And one, it certainly kindles the hope that these institutions are replicable and are being replicated in large numbers right now. And that is the divine mission which is taking off, of which we are all part, and we are eternally grateful for that sort of an opportunity which has been given to us to be part of the mission. These few words, Bhagwan, I wish to thank for the opportunity given, and take leave. Sai Ram.